Hey everyone, it's Mark Garcia here, and I wanted to make a very quick series of tutorials that's going to get you up and running quickly in one of the new apps that Microsoft has released on our Office 365 suite. So if you click on the app tray in the upper left-hand corner here and scroll all the way down, most likely, you're going to find an icon in your app tray for Teams. This is the new app we're talking about, and I wanted to kind of talk to you about why this is so beneficial. Now, if you don't want to go through all of that, the other thing you can do is in a browser window, just go to teams.microsoft.com, and it's going to prompt you to log in, and you're going to be able to log into your Teams account using your Colin credentials. So again, that's going to use your @colin.email address and then the password that's associated with your email, not CougarWeb, but your email. Okay, so this takes us into Teams. Now, why would you want to use this and how is this different from Groups? Well, Groups really kind of just built mailing lists, and it did have some of the features we're going to find here in Teams, but it was kind of confusing how it all worked together. Teams, as we're going to see, is a much more versatile platform. So if you're serving on a committee or you've got a group of colleagues and you're all trying to work towards a common goal, Teams is going to be an excellent way for you to accomplish that. So I'm going to start the way you would when you first log in, and that's by creating a new team. Now, when you first get here, you're going to get to this panel where you've got this kind of global navigation. It should look very familiar if you've used Canvas, and if you haven't, that's okay. But this is going to be your global nav bar where you have activity, chat, Teams, meetings, and files. Activity is going to give you updated notifications about people contacting you, places or teams you belong to, getting into discussions. Chat can be a one-on-one or multi-person discussion that can happen outside of a specific team. This is where you can actually just go to talk to people the same way you do with Jabber. We've got the Teams panel here, which I'm going to spend a lot of time in, meetings, and files. So I'll talk about all these in due time, but let's go ahead and get started with this. So if you've already created some teams, you're not going to see this here. Instead, to create new teams, you'll always click on Teams in the global navigation and then Add Team down at the bottom. If you haven't created any teams, then you can go ahead and just start by clicking this. So I'm going to create a team, and I'm going to call this Example Team. And I'm just going to say this is an example team. Now, I'm going to keep it private so that I can specifically invite certain people. And I'm going to do that because in this particular instance, I don't want anybody being able to just join from the college because this is obviously just for demo purposes. So then after I've set this up the way I want to, I'm going to say next. It's going to create the team. And now I can actually see that I've got the team over here. And right out of the gate, it's going to ask me, do I want to invite people? And I am. So you can either skip this if you're just trying to get a team set up, or if you want to actually start inviting people, then go ahead. And I'm going to invite a generic email address that I have, canvasfax@colin. So I've added that person. I'm going to close this. And I guess it is worth mentioning that at any point in time, I can view the members of the team by going to these three dots right next to the name of the team and saying View Team. And one thing I didn't touch upon when I first added CanvasFax was when I added this person, I had the option to actually change permissions, so I can either make them an owner or a member. I'm going to leave CanvasFax as a member, and I have a second laptop here where CanvasFax has been logged in, and so now CanvasFax has joined the team, and they're going to have similar options to what I have here, although because CanvasFax is not an owner, they don't get the option to add more people. They can suggest we add more people, but they can't actually add more people. But I can because I'm the owner of this team. Okay, so that's the general setup for setting up a brand new team. And again, if you want any options related to this team, just click on the three dots. You can choose to either have the team as a favorite or not. You can add a channel, view the team, you can add members, you can leave the team, you can edit the team, you can get a link to the team, and you can even delete the team. So I could literally delete this whole team if I wanted to, but I'm not going to. So let me go ahead and talk about this, because I think we all understand what View Team is going to allow us to do. I just showed you. Let's talk about add channels. So what are channels? Well, your team is a specific group of people. So for example, the ELC could be considered a team. Faculty Council could be considered a team. The OAB could be considered a team. What are channels? Well, channels can be distinct directives in your team. So, for example, if the ELC is going to be hosting summer workshops, they could create a summer workshops channel. And that's where they could have any discussions, they could upload any files, they could talk about anything related to those summer workshops. So I'm going to go ahead and do that here in my example team. I've got a general channel, which is where we can just go to have any kind of talk related to this team. But I'm going to add a second channel. And let's call this All College Day. I'm going to add that there. So I now have this All College Day channel. I'm going to add another channel as well. I'm going to add one called Smart Bar. So for those of you who don't know, I have helped with the student-based Smart Bar previously, so I'm going to add that here as though my example team is going to be responsible for it.